This is Father Jim Korda. On behalf of your Catholic friends and neighbors in the Diocese of Youngstown, I invite you to join us for this celebration of the Holy Mass.
Good morning, and welcome to St. Paul's. Today is the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is Father Korda. Please stand.
Enter the journey, come to the song. By God you are chosen, by name you are called to follow the mission, carry the cross. Enter the journey of faith as the family of God. Enter the journey, the way may be long. Enter the journey, and we are made strong. God's Spirit will guide us, God's gifts will unfold. Enter the journey of hope. Enter the journey, come to the song. By God you are chosen, by name you are called to follow the vision, carry the cross. Enter the journey of faith as the family of God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
It's good to see you today and to welcome you as we gather in the Lord's presence to hear the word and to celebrate the Eucharist. So mindful of God present, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us join the angels in their hymn of praise. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband entrusting his heart to her as an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those, blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those, blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways, for you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored. Blessed are those, blessed are those who fear the Lord. Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your home. Your children like olive plants around your table. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Blessed are those, blessed are those who fear the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourself know very well that the day of the Lord will come, like a thief at night. When people are saying, peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
With
our reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1. to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately, the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off, dug a hole in the ground, and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing the additional 5. He said, "Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received 2 talents also came forward and said, "Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I've made 2 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who received the 1 talent came forward and said, "Master, I knew you were a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant and gathering where you did not scatter. So out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back." His master said to him in reply, "You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord. My friends, there's a short poem written by a Marguerite Wilkinson entitled "Guilty." It goes like this. "I never cut my neighbor's throat. My neighbor's purse I never stole. I never spoiled their house or land, but God have mercy on my soul. For I am haunted night and day by all the deeds I have not done, the unattempted loveliness, the costly valor never won." Well, today's gospel parable certainly dramatizes that very theme. You know, the person in the parable started with 1 silver piece and ended with 1 silver piece. They didn't lose anything, but they didn't gain anything. They didn't do anything right, wrong, but they didn't do anything right. In the strictest sense of the word, they did not fail. They just didn't try. And for that, they receive one of the sternest reprimands to be found in the New Testament. Paul Harvey, the late newscaster, talks about a group of people whose slogan in life is this: "There is no use trying. Nothing is going to turn out okay anyway." Well, if I felt that way, I wouldn't try either. You know, cynicism is more than just a philosophy. Cynicism is a debilitating disease that works its way into the very tissues of the human soul, and it paralyzes every effort of healthy living. You know, cynicism was just one of the problems with the man in today's gospel parable. His other problem was fear of failure. Listen to him. "Out of fear, I buried your talent in the ground." That's what he said. His reasoning was that it was better to not try than to try and fail. he could not have been more wrong. You see, it isn't a sin to fail, not if you try. The only real failure is the failure to try. Have you ever stopped to consider how Jesus might have failed? You might find it strange that I would even say such a thing, but it's true. You know, Jesus failed with Judas Iscariot. He failed with some of the Jewish officials. He failed at times with his own family. We should be encouraged by that. Encouraged at least to try. If Jesus failed, it certainly isn't a sin. The only real failure is the failure to try. Don't bury your life in the ground. That's what Jesus is simply saying. You know, this world is hurting for so many things. So many things that we have the ability to share. If you have the gift of love, or honesty, or justice, or the capacity for any virtue, dig it up, dust it off, and put it to work. And don't worry about the results, Jesus said. Let's just use what God has given us. And perhaps someday we will hear, "Well done, you are industrious and reliable. Come share my joy." Let us please stand and together profess the faith that we all share. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Humbly now let us present to God our special petitions.
For the Church, that the Holy Spirit may bind us with the same love, untying us in hurt, so that we may carry out God's will in the world today, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newly elected officials, that we may fulfill their duties with integrity and work untiringly to address the crucial issues of our society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus, that the Holy Spirit will bring healing to those who are healed, give strength and wisdom to those who care for them, and inspiration to those working on a vaccine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the homebound and the sick, that God will protect them, renew their spirits, and restore them to wholeness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those seeking employment, that God will lead them to opportunities to use their gift and talents in life-giving and productive ways. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we pray this Mass, let us remember Debbie Blaylock and all the holy souls in purgatory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God in heaven, we praise and thank you for the countless blessings and talents you have given each of us. As we strive to share those with those most in need, one day welcome us to the fullness of your love and peace in heaven. We make this prayer in the Spirit through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ your Son. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Paul, Blessed James Alberioni, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of Christ be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Body Christ.
Happy the ones who you call here to dine, the saints and the sinners, your friends. Now reconciled in this banquet divine, the promise of life without end.
Body Christ.
Of life without
Body
end.
Christ.
Here in your presence, the greatest are least, the burden find
Body
rest,
Christ.
And the hungry can feast. By love we're invited here, mercy prevails. God, in your goodness we
Body
share
Christ.
A place at your table. Place at your
Body
table.
Body Christ.
From this communion in
Body
one
Christ.
Heart and mind,
you
out
Body
into
Christ.
Mission we go.
Body Christ.
No greater love shall the world ever find, and none shall we ever know. And none shall we ever know. At your table.
I'd like to thank you for coming to celebrate Mass today. I wish you a blessed Sunday and a safe week. Let us stand and pray. We have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mysteries, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be.